All right, howdy. Welcome to the Online Executive Master of Public Service and Administration Programs virtual information session with tracks in Homeland Security, Nonprofit Management, and Public Management. This session is offered and delivered to you by Texas A&M University's Bush School of Government and Public Service. My name is Lisa Brown. I'm the director of the Office of Extended Education here at the Bush School of Government and Public Service. During this presentation, if at any time you need help or assistance, please feel free to contact our advising center. And we're available Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 p.m. Central Time, toll free at 1-866-988-2874. That's 1-866-988-2874. Or you can email us at any time at bushschoolonline@tamu.edu. That's bushschoolonline@tamu.edu. But we encourage you to reach out if you have any questions about the program or the admissions process. We're here to help you. So please contact us. So today, what we're going to learn is we're going to get an overview of the EMPSA program. But first, this time we save the best for the first. So we have an EMPSA alumnus joining us of Mr. John Whitehead. And he's going to tell you about his experience in the program, some of the values, some of the benefits, and just what it was like to go through the EMPSA program. Also, we're going to talk about the Bush School and Texas A&M University. We'll go over some of the rankings and reputations of both the Bush School and Texas A&M. We're going to talk about the benefits of the EMPSA program, the curriculum, some potential careers you can pursue, and then we'll end up talking about the application and cost of the program and potential ways you can fund your EMPSA program. But first, I'd like to introduce John Whitehead. He's the VP of Sales for North America for Hexagon, and he's also our distinguished alumni. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to John to talk and to tell you about his experience in the program, and then we'll give you the opportunity to ask him questions. John.
Howdy, and thanks, Lisa, for letting me speak. Can you hear me okay?
Yes, absolutely.
Great. I do have my camera on. I don't know if you can see me or not, but you know what? That's probably either way, it works for me. So thank you guys for giving me a few minutes just to speak about this. I was actually excited and honored to be asked to join you. I just graduated this past May through the EMPSA program. And man, I just can't be more excited about this. I'll give you a little bit about my background. I started in public service, was on the public safety side, and it was, I think I started when I was 13 years old as a junior volunteer fire department member. So I got a lot of family that's been in the fire service over the years. In my 20s, jumped in on the 911 side, worked my way through the ranks there, and ended up running a 911 center for several years. Early 2000, around 2003, I decided to leave the public sector, but stay in the business. And I've been with Hexagon now since 2003. And we're a company that provides software and services for public safety agencies all across the globe. I had my undergrad in business management, and I had been looking around for a master's program. I lucked out. I've actually got my executive VP went through the program, and one of our project managers went through the program. They were, I think, one of the first few. I know the project manager claims that he was the first class to graduate through this program. So they got me all fired up on it. I started digging around into it, and you know, I hadn't been in school for a long while, so I was a little apprehensive. And so I started going through, and I started with the certificate program. I decided, you know what, I'll take one class over the summer, I'll take one class each semester, and just kind of baby step my way into it, instead of just jumping in and having to deal with all of it hit me at once. For me, it worked out great because I was able to kind of slow crawl into it, learn how you know, learn how to incorporate studying and class type of stuff into a full-time job, full-time family, and, you know, everything else that we've got going on in the world. After two semesters, I took a single class in the summer, single class that fall, and I was ready. I mean, I was all in, and I signed up, finished the certificate program, applied, and then was accepted to go on and finish the master's degree. Again, my experience with the program has been really, really good. I mean, it's just been one of those things that, you know, I live in St. Louis, Missouri. I'm born and raised here, so I'm not, you know, just around the corner from College Station. So I was a little apprehensive on that as well, right? How's this going to be studying and learning and, you know, working with other classmates and instructors and stuff through these classes. And I got to say that I was pleasantly surprised right out of the gate. Faculty is engaged and available. They're responsive. A lot of things are, you know, everything's online, of course. And as you're engaging with the other people in your class, it was just awesome to be able to see other professionals in the industry kind of give their thoughts. So we had people in the military, people in, you know, police officers, you know, executive command staff, some from federal. And as I engaged with these people, it was just a great feeling to be able to get their perspectives and kind of hear things. I got to say, at the beginning, I looked and thought, man, this is going to take a long time. And, you know, I remember talking to some of my coworkers who had been through it and says, you know, this just feels like a long haul. And I got to tell you, it blinked. And next thing I know, I'm in my fall semester starting this capstone. Again, I just can't say enough good things about it. The capstone, it's a great experience because my class was lucky enough to get a client. We got the FBI as our client, and we started off and we were told what our capstone was going to be about. And there was 11 of us in the capstone program that was all working on this. And I remember the first call we got on, and everybody said the exact same thing. I don't know anything about this topic. I'm going to really have to dig in. And within about 30 days, we quickly became experts in the topic that we were researching. And just the fun of experiencing that, I think, was something that just continued to drive us. And by spring, April of this year, we were able to give our presentation to the FBI, and we got to actually go to DC and do that in person. We then were asked to go and give the presentation to a couple other organizations up in DC, and successfully got through the capstone program. Went to graduation in May. And when I started, I said, you know what, I'm way too old to wear a cap and gown and get up on the stage and do this kind of stuff. But I put the gown on and walked proudly across that stage. And, you know, it's funny now, in daily life now, I say things like howdy and gig'em and whoop. So it's, I'm all in on the Aggie experience. So that's a little bit about me, a little bit about my background. I'll see if there's any questions. I do see one question in the chat that asks which track I pursued. I went through the Homeland Security track. So I started off with taking classes like cybersecurity, border security, port security, and terrorism. Those were some of the classes that I jumped on and kind of kicked out with. But the Homeland Security track for me was just a perfect fit. I use that now in my daily life as I'm out giving presentations, talking to public safety agencies throughout North America. You know, I can at least relate to what they're going through, and everything from budgeting all the way down to some of the policies that they're getting from the feds. It's worked well for me.
Oh, and also something I wanted to share with y'all, John Whitehead was actually our commencement speaker at Reed Arena, and he knocked it out of the park. So I have a slide and links to that I will share with y'all later, so y'all can actually look at his speech, and he gives more of the EMPSA experience in that too. So that was exciting because it was a surprise to all of us. We didn't even know he was the commencement speaker, and like, oh, wow, there's John.
Yeah. You know, the rest of my class didn't either. They were all out on the floor. The rest of my capstone team was out on the floor, and I hadn't said anything to them just to see if, you know, we could keep it a surprise. And apparently they were like, you know, where's Whitehead at? He should be. He said he's going to be here. Why is he not here? Is his flight delayed? And all of a sudden I come walking up on the stage. So that was an honor. And I was, I, it was pumped to be selected for that and be able to give that presentation. And yeah, I think you got a picture of me in my gown, which, you know, we'll keep that one personal opinions aside. There was one more question here. It says, where was your first, was this your first online degree and where was your bachelor's degree from? No is the answer to was this my first online degree? My bachelor and my undergrad is through WGU, Western Governors University. And I actually went through that and kind of, that kind of threw me into an online program. That one's a little more self-study, a little more, you kind of got to, you know, you got to be all in on that as far as you're pushing yourself through. When I came into this program, I thought, okay, it's probably going to be very similar. And I was actually surprised at how different it was. The engagement of the faculty here, the ability to speak with other people that's taking the same class. There's a lot more camaraderie, I think, in this program. And to me, that was something that I enjoyed over my undergrad. How many in-person visits did I have to Texas A&M? Was the entire program online? So I think, Lisa, I think it's a hybrid program is what I think it's set up as. And
I can answer that question.
Yeah,
so as far as the required in-person visits, the requirements are that you just attend the two separate one-week residency weeks. So those are the main requirements because your capstone presentations can be delivered remotely. So the main requirement is those two in-person residency weeks. Now, we encourage you to do things like come to graduation celebration, Aggie Ring Days, and there are a lot of special events that you'll be invited to, but not required. So that only requirement is that two in-person residency weeks. Good question. And then as far as the normal capstone group size, it really does vary. I mean, we've had capstones as small as 4 or 5 students to capstones as large as 20. I'd say if I averaged it out, it's been running between 8 and 10. But there is a wide range in the capstone sizes. Great questions, everyone. Let's see if y'all have any other questions for John, please put them in the chat. yeah, and something to keep in mind for the residency weeks, the travel, the student is responsible for their own travel.
Yeah, and I know some of the, whenever the second residency week, right, you've already been in the program for a while, you know some people, and I know that there's been several that's kind of got together and did a, you know, like an Airbnb type of thing and rented out a house. So I've had, you know, experiences with that. Our capstone apps actually happened during the whole COVID thing. So we did that residency week remotely. So that one was all via Teams, and Lisa and the team did a great job of I'll say making do. You know, they made sure that we got all the information we needed, but depending on how you're looking at it, we lucked out and didn't have to go down there for that one. But I actually looked at it as a little bit of a disappointment. It was like, I really wanted to go down. The only thing I'd add is now that I'm ingrained in the whole A&M experience, I've been down there numerous times for football games. Was just down there a couple of weeks ago and actually had a chance to be there for the Alabama beating that occurred when A&M took them down here just a few weeks ago. So that was exciting. And I'm looking towards, because of the people that I've met, there's people that are in the program that may not graduate when you do. They may be, you know, the capstone behind you, but you may have taken a couple classes. I've developed some good friendships here over the last few years. So I'm looking at going down December 17th, I think, for their graduation. So it's exciting. It's a lot of good stuff.
Excellent. And we're so glad that you visit and stay a part of Texas A&M University. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to unmute, give everyone the ability to unmute themselves just for a little bit in case if anyone can't get to the chat so they can ask their questions. And that includes the conference phones too. So I will allow you to ask you to unmute if you want to ask a question via audio, you're more than welcome to. Last call, anyone have any questions for John?
That was easy, Lisa. So thank you very much, guys, for letting me come in here and talk to you guys. I'll throw up the ring and say gig them to everybody, and good luck. Can't say it enough. Sign up. You're going to have a good time with this program, and it's well worth it.
Woo! Thank you, John. We appreciate it, and we appreciate your time. And if any of you prospective students have questions that you think of later, feel free to send them to us. And we can be sure and ask those and get those answers to you. But John does have another meeting that he has to go to. So we're going to go ahead and let him go. Again, thank you, John. We sure appreciate you being here and giving the student experience. Okay, and you're getting lots of thanks in the chat, John. So thanks again, we appreciate it. So I'm gonna go ahead and go back to our presentation and share that presentation with you. So give me one moment to transition here. Okay, and hopefully everyone should be able to see on the screen the PowerPoint with John's picture on it. So let's see if I could get a couple. Awesome. I got a thumbs up that y'all can see it. Very good. Okay. So this is a picture of John when he was graduating and speaking at Reed Arena. So there, I will send you this presentation next week so you can click on the links and view the links and learn a little bit more. But I encourage you to go and read the article and read his speech because it really gives you insight into the EMPSA program, what it's like from the student experience even more. Also, I wanted to let you know on our website, we do have an alumni success stories link attached to our EMPSA website. And I highly encourage you to go to that link and you can read more about our alumni and student success. All right, so but I want to go ahead and transition and talk a little bit about Texas A&M University, because not everyone is familiar with Texas A&M University, but we are a Tier 1 research university. We are the first public university in Texas and one of two flagship universities in Texas. We're also one of the few universities in the country to be designated a land grant, sea grant, and space grant university. We're also a member of the Association of American Universities since 2001. And we're also among the nation's five largest universities with an enrollment of 71,209 students in fall 2020. So Texas A&M University, we have a great website that talks all about our recognitions, that gives a lot of statistics that about our students and our student success. So if you go to accountability.tamu.edu/recognitions, you can learn more about Texas A&M's core distinguishing recognitions and awards too that we've received. So for example, we're ranked 11th in the nation and 5th among public universities in overall monies ranking. We're also listed 8th in the nation and 5th among public universities for best colleges for business and engineering majors. We're also 4th in the nation in best value schools among AAU universities. We're 4th in the nation among public universities and 12th among both public and private, according to Washington Monthly 2020. And those are just a few of the accolades. Now, the Bush School of Government and Public Service, we are a graduate school within Texas A&M University. And our Bush School mission is to educate students, to explore knowledge building, and to engage our communities, nations, and the world through a lifelong commitment to public service. So as a part of that vision, our mission, our actual vision is to inspire excellence in the noble calling of public service. our school was based on the philosophy of the 41st president, George H.W. Bush, who believed that public service is a noble calling. And that belief continues to shape all aspects of our school's curriculum, research, and student experience. We really are about serving the public, helping others, and the belief that public service is a noble calling. And please be aware, we're a nonpartisan school. That means you'll see a broad range of spectrum of beliefs and values. But I'd say one of the things that really connects us together, though, is that belief in public service and the importance of public service and helping others. And again, our mission is to educate, explore, and engage. The Bush School, we've increased in rankings as well. So if you look at bush.tamu.edu/about, if you look at that website, you'll find that we're in the top 10% of graduate public affairs schools in the nation, according to U.S. News and World Report 2021. We're also 16th in public affairs programs among public universities, according to U.S. News and World Report 2021. And finally, we're first in the nation for best value for executive online Master of Public Administration programs, according to Value Colleges 2020. Additionally, we're also accredited by the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools Commission on Colleges, or SAC, COC, and we're accredited by NASPA. And NASPA is the Network of Schools of Public Policy, Affairs, and Administration, and they represent the global standard in public service, public administration education. So we are a NASPA accredited school. For the curriculum for the EMPSA, it's comprised of 13 courses, and typically students will take PSAA 601, that's Public Service Foundations, the first semester it's offered. The Public Service Foundations has 1 week in residence attached to that week, and so typically you'll start your first couple of weeks of online class, and then the third week you'll be in College Station, Texas for your residency week. Our students also take PSAA 675, the capstone course, the next to the last semester in their program. Our capstone, and that is the applied research course, where you actually look and see, you investigate a research question or a problem in public service, and you investigate it, suggest solutions. So our capstone course is a 2-semester capstone, and you take 675, 676, the capstone course back to back. And so that's important when you're planning out your curriculum if you apply and are accepted to the EMPSA program. We do have admissions each fall, spring, and summer semester. And wanted to mention about the online master's program. So it's 13 courses, 39 graduate credit hours. We have 2 separate 1 weeks in residence required, and that is in person. Our tracks are Homeland Security, Nonprofit, or Public Management track. And in the EMPSA program, you must choose one of the tracks. And the capstone course, again, it's a applied capstone with industry government partners. And something to keep in mind, if you've already completed a Bush School graduate certificate in Homeland Security, Nonprofit Management, or Public Management, you can apply that credit up to 12 credit hours to the related track. So again, if you have Bush School graduate certificate hours, those can potentially apply to the EMPSA program. Also, I wanted to let you know about our graduate certificate options. So sometimes our students will start pursuing a graduate certificate of certificate in nonprofit management, homeland security, or public management, either before they apply to the EMPSA or even in conjunction while they're applying for the EMPSA. You can pursue a graduate certificate at the same time you're pursuing your executive master's degree. And there are some cases where one course may apply between the EMPSA master's and the graduate certificate. So there are some cases where that may be an option as well. Sometimes we have students who just decide, you know, kind of like John was saying, I'm going to dip my toes in and try a graduate certificate first, maybe just take a course or two, and then apply to the EMPSA program. So that's an option as well. So there are varying options depending on what your career goals are. And also think about what your work obligations are and what your schedule is. So those are important things to think about moving forward. Now, I did want to talk a little bit about residency weeks. So right now we have residency weeks in College Station, Texas, and those residency weeks typically occur in the summer and fall semester. We are also going to start offering a residency week option in Washington, D.C. beginning in fall 2022. So that will be an option. As far as residency weeks, how that will work is we will begin to transition to offer 3 residency weeks a year as an option to students, and students can mix and match locations. So for example, let's say you want all your residency weeks in College Station. Well, then you can plan it that way. And just know eventually we're going to have those residency weeks in the spring and the summer sessions in College Station, whereas we're planning residency weeks to occur in fall sessions. But again, this is just one more option for our students that we're building in so they can identify what are their career goals and also to give them more opportunities in regard to information sessions, in regard to residency weeks. So for example, this upcoming summer 2022, we'll have residency week in College Station, Texas. And we're offering both the first year residency week of PSAA 601, Public Service Foundations, and the capstone. And that has already been scheduled because Texas A&M has published their calendar, and that will be June 13th through 17th, 2022. Now for fall 2022, we're gonna offer the PSAA 601 Public Service Foundations residency week in Washington, DC, while we're offering the capstone in College Station. And that's just to finish up the capstone because we had some students who were already planning for capstone in College Station. Also, the heads up, that one for fall 2022 is tentatively planned September 12th through 16th for the residency week. We're awaiting the final Texas A&M schedule before we plan that fall 2022 residency week date. We're gonna have a spring 2023 residency in College Station, Texas, and that's tentatively by enrollment. So if we get enough student interest, we'll hold one in the spring in 2023. Pardon me. And then in summer 2023, we'll hold another residency week in College Station. So essentially by fall 2023, we'll have a residency in DC and then spring and summer residencies in College Station. Now for each residency week, please be advised that the travel costs are the responsibility of the student as well as a hotel. However, what we do is we block hotel rooms and we give students the opportunity to book at that hotel block and then they just pay for their room. So again, you pay for your travel and transportation, your hotel room, and your incidentals during residency week. Now, while you're here, We do provide the lunches during the week for residency week, and we usually have breakfast snacks as well as afternoon snacks. Okay, so that's a little bit about residency week. Now I want to move to what are the benefits of a EMPSA degree? So of course, you know, your first benefit is it is a master's degree from an accredited, well-known university of Texas A&M University. Your diploma reads Master of Public Service and Administration, and then your Texas A&M University transcript notes the executive program. Also, upon successful graduation, you'll have a Bush School document noting your specific track. So whether it be Homeland Security, public management, or nonprofit management. Also, one of the biggest benefits that our students love is just the networking between Texas A&M faculty, students, and alumni, and also as well as the Bush School alumni. Also, you can join the Texas A&M Aggie Network. So our Aggie Network, we have a huge association of former students. It's very active throughout the United States and even worldwide. And it's amazing just the power of the Aggie Network and Aggie Ring. So a lot of our students will purchase a graduation ring, an Aggie Ring, once they complete 75% of their coursework. And I'll tell you what, it's amazing. If you're wearing your Aggie Ring and are in an airport, invariably you'll have another Aggie come up to you and introduce themselves. So, but we have a great, wonderful Aggie Network with Aggie clubs throughout the United States. What will you learn in the EMPSA program? You'll really learn a lot of critical thinking skills. You'll develop your writing even more. You'll refine your skills of analysis and critical thinking. And also, of course, through your applied research course, you will enhance your research skills. You'll learn some budgetary management concepts, as well as refine your leadership expertise, and you'll complete a culminating applied research project as well, and that's the capstone. So here is the core curriculum, and all EMPSA students take these courses. They're required courses. You can't get out of it. So it's 21 hours of core courses that our majors take. You take PSAA 601, Foundations of Public Service, mostly online, and that includes the 1 week on campus. You take PSAA 611, Public Policy Formation, Economic Analysis, Program Evaluation, Quantitative Methods, and then your Capstone Seminar 1 and 2. The Homeland Security track, you'll have, if you choose that track, you'll have required Homeland Security courses of budgeting and public service, public management, and fundamentals of Homeland Security. And then you'll choose 3 online course electives from a list of Homeland Security approved electives. For nonprofit management track, if you choose that track, you'll complete Foundations of the Nonprofit Sector, Management and Leadership of Nonprofit Organizations, and Fiscal Management for Nonprofits. And then you'll choose 3 course electives from a listing of online course electives in nonprofit management. Or if you choose the public management track, you'll complete the required courses of budgeting and public service, public management, foundations of the nonprofit sector, and then you choose 3 course electives from a listing of online public management electives. So one of the questions that we get is, what are your online courses like? Well, first, the important thing to note is that there's no class meeting times, except during those 2 weeks, the 1 week twice, and residency weeks in person. And you may have a few meetings in preparation for Capstone, where you try to get all of your group together in order to plan for the Capstone research project. However, typically in those meetings, there is some flexibility in that if something does come up, you just have to communicate with your classmates. So the beauty of your online courses is you don't have to drop anything. and be someplace except during residency week. You are required to make the virtual presentation for the final capstone presentation, and something to keep in mind. And also, our courses are interactive courses with online lectures, and we use a lot of threaded discussion. So your faculty member may post a question, and then you'll have to research answers and respond with appropriate citations and answer those questions and discuss with your peers and colleagues. So a lot of threaded discussion for your faculty and student interaction. We also still have textbooks, and some of our courses offer optional webinars where you can, or other way to think about it is optional office hours where you can visit with the faculty in Zoom, chat with them, and ask your question. But something to keep in mind is your courses still have deadlines. You're going to have deadlines due every week and materials due every week. So you'll have, when you get that syllabus, what I always recommend students do, put it on your calendar, note all the deadlines, and be sure that you work toward, you have to meet those deadlines. And when you can, get ahead. Something to keep in mind, you also must participate. What you don't want to do is just start a course and just disappear. So it's very important that you participate in your course weekly and remain active, and that's critical. Also, the courses are taught by experts in the field with academic credentials. So our faculty, they have both the practical experience, but they also have the academic credentials of terminal degrees in their field. But something to keep in mind, even though this is very rigorous and it will take work, it's achievable. It's something you can do. And so keep that in mind. We have a variety of support services. We have 24-hour a day, 7-day a week technical support. We offer online library services. Our library is amazing. I tell students all the time, ask your librarian questions. They can save you so much time in the research process. We even have chat with a lot of librarians so that you can chat the librarian your questions. We have career services at Texas A&M, and we also have Bush School Career Services. Our Bush School Career Services, they won't find you a job, but what they will do is they will connect you with the resources to help you work toward achieving that career or the career goal that you want to. So they provide things like CV or resume reviews. They'll also connect you with alumni in the field that you're wanting to go into so that you can ask advice or make that important connection. We also have alumni networking groups, a writing center. We have our online advising center. And we also invite you to events on campus. We share recorded webinars. And we highly encourage you to attend graduation and EMPSA graduation celebration. It's not required, but we do highly encourage you to attend graduation. So who can apply to the EMPSA program? So those with a bachelor's degree from an accredited university can apply. You also must have 5 years full-time cumulative experience in public service with 3 years at the middle to upper level. And when you do apply, be sure to highlight your supervisory and management experience. So when you're looking at that mid to upper level experience, what the review committee is looking at is your supervisory and management experience. Also highlight any track related experience. The application process involves sending in your application through what's called Graduate CAS, and that's an $89 fee domestic to apply, $114 fee international to apply. We also need your official transcripts, and send us your unofficial transcripts as well. You can upload those to GradCast. We'll also ask that you send us your resume And on our website, we have a listing of items that you should include on your resume. You'll also need to complete your statement of purpose. So this is an essay, a formal essay, where you tell us your goals for obtaining the EMPSA degree. You'll also describe your public service experience, and you'll talk about the range of your public service experience, including any management or supervisory experience you may have. And you'll answer questions such as, what did you do? What were your duties and responsibilities? What were some of your achievements? Describe the unique value that you will bring to the program. So you'll basically, in that essay, tell us your goals for obtaining your Master of Public Service and Administration, as well as telling us about your public service experience and your management and supervisory experience. If your native language is not English, then we'll need your TOEFL or IELTS scores. And keep in mind that the GRE is optional in applying for the EMPSA program, but it's strongly recommended to submit a GRE or GMAT score that's no older than 5 years if your grade point average was below 3.2. So something to keep in mind. Also, if you need to strengthen your application, then it's a good idea to include a GRE or GMAT score. So for example, let's say you had a really fun first year in your undergraduate, and so your grade point isn't what you know you could have done. So in that case, you may want to consider taking that GRE or GMAT. Or let's say you made below a C in your statistics and math-based courses. And so, you know, in that case, you may want to take the GRE or the GMAT. So if you have a component in your application that is weak, that GRE or GMAT score could help you. Something to keep in mind is that we do have a quantitative methods course as well as an economic analysis course. And so that's why those good grades and those statistics and math courses are a good component to show in your application. So apply today. We accept applications each semester, fall, spring, summer. The deadline for our spring 2022 applications are November 21st, 2021. So we're headed toward November very quickly. Our deadline for summer 2022 is March 20th, 2022. And then our deadline for fall 2022 is July 10th, 2022. What is the cost of our program? So the EMPSA estimated cost per online course is based on your residency per Texas law. So if you're an in-state Texas resident, it's approximately $2,703 a course. If you're a non-resident living outside of Texas, it's approximately $4,382 a course. And there's additional charges for international students. All students have a general deposit of $100 on their first semester's bill and a new grad student fee of $50 on that first semester's bill. If you are a distance education student in Brazos County and the seven surrounding counties, you're charged an additional $320 a semester, but that $320 a semester gives you access to our recreational facility as well as our health facilities. International students also have a service fee of $46 a semester and a fee for a third-party sponsored international students. So now that leads to the next question. How can you fund your EMPSA program? Well, the first step is to fill out the free application for federal student aid. That's the first step, to see what you may qualify. Even though you may have a full-time job, the cost of the education are taken into account too. So I highly recommend you fill that out. Also, if you're active duty military or if you're a veteran, please, please contact our Texas A&M Veterans Services. And they're a very well-recognized veteran services support area here at Texas A&M University, and they can help investigate to let you know if you're eligible for any tuition and fee reimbursement, Hazelwood program, if you're eligible for any exemptions. So definitely contact them if you're a veteran or active duty military. The other option that we have is the Bush School Online Student Scholarship for Texas residents, and Texas residents can also apply for the Texas Aggie Grant. Both of those are need-based grants, but highly recommend you apply for those each semester. Also, check with any organizations of which you're a member. See if they offer any tuition reimbursement or scholarship programs. We'll also share with you a Texas A&M Scholarships and Waivers website so you can see if you are eligible for any of the scholarships or waivers. And finally, check with your place of employment to see if there's any programs for educational reimbursement or educational support. And be sure to connect with us. But now I'm going to look through the chat and see what questions we may have had. Everybody, please do feel free to put your questions in the chat, and we'll be happy to look at those. Also, let me see if Scott, yep. And we also have an alumni, Scott Fisher, who was answering questions with us here. If you would like to ask some more questions of Scott, please feel free to put those in the chat, and you can ask our EMPSA alumni, Scott. Okay, so we have one question. Would a lack of supervisory experience hurt your application? And the question, it really depends. So for example, if you have a strong experience in budgets, which could be considered management experience as well, that could help your application. Excuse me, everybody. And it really just depends upon the entire context of your application. But I would recommend either some sort of budgetary experience or supervisory experience to show that you have that mid to upper level experience. So let's see. So to show that you have at least that 3 years of the middle to upper level experience. Good question. We also had a question, is it possible to take one class at a time or are the classes overlapping? You can take one class at a time. You can take two classes at a time. We even have some students who don't have as heavy a work schedule who can take three classes at a time. So yes, you can. So our fall classes are 15-week classes. Our spring classes are 15 week, and then our summer classes are 10 week. So we actually follow the traditional schedule of the semester. Something to keep in mind, if you need need-based financial aid, then you have to take two courses in the fall in order to qualify for financial aid for in the form of low interest loans and two in the spring. However, only takes one course in the summer to qualify for that financial aid. But yes, you can take multiple classes at the same time. Okay, and as far as if you have a graduate degree and had an appropriate, a good GPA, and also you had the public service experience and the management supervisory experience, then in that case, most likely you would be in good shape. So again, the GRE, it's more, let's say you had the low math scores, a low grade point, and you really needed to strengthen your application. So in that's the case where that GRE would be recommended. Good question. And so I just put that slide up here. So basically for GPAs below the 3.2, and if you had the low math scores or a performance lapse, so in that case, it would be more recommended. We're glad that you joined us and that you can learn more about the Executive Master of Public Service and Administration. Please don't hesitate to call us in the Advising Center with your questions, and we'll be sending you a follow-up email next week. Again, thank you. It was so great to have you all here. Bye-bye.